Good god Tar chose this beauty among mountains to live his godly life at it. Every year, thousands of tourists rush to this goddess among mountains. Being of unbelievable, almost fabulous beauty, unique and rare, Tara simply lures. It all started at the beginning of the last century when Milovan Glišić, for health reasons, stayed at Tara in 1905. There are written documents that our famous narrator stayed in the monastery palaces not far from the place where the hotel Omorika is, to heal his ill lungs. The first buildings to which tourists came were the property of the Rača monastery. It was a home of mountaineers with capacity of 60 beds in the locality of the Kalujerske bare, the monks' ponds. It was among the first ones in the provinces of Serbia. This is how it all started. The mountain of Tara is embraced by the Drina River in its large curve from Visegrad to Bajna Bašta, penetrating through serpentine and limestone rocks of the mountains, separating with its course Bosnian hills from Serbia. The massif of Tara Mountain is in the western part of Serbia, bordered with the river and canyon of the Drina from the northwest, and with its southeast part and branches, it descends towards the Kremna plateau of the Jetinja valley, leaning on the Zlatibor branches. The nature of this amazing mountain has always extended hospitality. Long continuity of life at Tara drew as far back as to Neolith. It is also known that at the mountain of Tara, along the upper and middle course of Drina, the Illyrian tribe of the Otariate lived. And after their stay in these regions, the names of the mountain and the river of Tara remained, as well as of the river of Drina, Čigota, etc. During the period of Byzantine dominance in the Balkans, the areas of the Tara mountain, the canyons of the rivers Drina and Rača, represented natural and inaccessible border of defense in the furthest north. The Rača monastery represents the most significant and attractive cultural and historical value of this region. This monastery of the Holy Christ Ascension is situated in the village of Rača, located on the right bank of the small river with the same name, on the plateau near the canyon among the eastern slopes of the Tara mountain. This was written down by Joachim Vujić in 1826 during his stay in this Nemanjić sanctity. The monastery is the memorial of King Dragutin and was built in the second half of the 13th century in tradition of the Raška school. It was burnt more times, torn down and plundered. It was a center of the medieval Serbian coping literature.
Hadži Melentije Stefanović renewed it in 1785, but the Turks of Memisaga from Srebrenica tore it down to its foundations in 1813.
It was rebuilt in 1828 and repaired and renewed several times after that. The interior of the monastery is rich with frescoes and icons, and the iconostas is believed to be among the most beautiful ones in Serbia. The tower with a bell dominates the monastery complex, 12 meters high. It is secluded under the cliffs of the Jelenska Stena, the Deer's Rock, in the forests which surround it. Nowadays, the Rača monastery remains the seat of the spirit and culture of the people from this region. That year, when St. George's Day falls into the Good Friday, the Drina will flow through Tara. Mitar Tarabić said, and so it happened. At the beginning of the 80s of the last century, in the very bosom of Tara, in the village of Zaovine, the first reversible water power station in Europe was built. The Beli Rzav accumulation was not only a vision of the prophets from Kremna, but also a genuine miracle of builders. Somehow within years, this creation of man assimilated with this gorgeous ambience. And down there, the Drina curves and curves. To be honest, man tended as well to suit his needs. It happened in the 60s of the last century by building the water power station in Peručac. In the old times it was called Drinos, and people, because of its unique color, call it Zelenica, the green one. It hollowed the canyon into limestone rocks for centuries, leaving monumental stone sculptures. The canyon of the Drina is the third one in the world with regards to its size after the Grand Canyon and the canyon of the Tara River. But as to its beauty, it does not fall behind. In the time of rafting, the foreigners called it the Serbian Niagara because of its numerous stone partitions, cataracts, which created outstanding waterfalls. Nowadays, the Drina is tamed with dams. The lake covered many rafting sightseeings and swallowed the great part of the canyon. But in spite of it all, it has the attribute of our most beautiful river. Evoking memories and the fairy tale times of rafting down the Drina every summer, the famous regatta on the Drina is organized, which is included into the calendar of the most famous sports tourism and entertainment recreational happenings in our country. The Drina is ranked among the cleanest water flows in Serbia. Being as such, it is a natural domicile of salmonids, queens of the ichthyological world, huntsman, trout, grayling and other fish. Pleasure and adventure of this river is really exceptional, but what for sure takes your breath away is a look onto the canyon of the Drina from a place with a good view. Whether it is the Banjska or the Biljaška Stena, you dream about the scene from their views. It is because these places are most similar to paradise. I long to keep this beauty which has appeared in front of me, and finally the longing is satisfied. Tula Margaret Camilla. The rocks overgrown with thick moss have dried out a long time ago in the heat of July. That scene is contrary to the name of the shortest river in the world, the Vrela. Spring River is 360 meters long in the ratio of meters and day. In that rare coincidence, it is known as the river year. In its short but very stormy flow, the Vrelo has no time for curving. Simply with a small deviation from the trajectory of the straight line, it flows through Peručac, the place which is leaning onto the right bank of the Drina River. Really, in that unique triangle, Tara, Drina and Vrelo, a man cannot stay indifferent. The two rivers, the mountain, give miraculous note of unreality which permeates all senses. With the power of a giant, in the magnificent scene, the Vrela with a gorgeous waterfall almost crazily falls into the Drina, thus giving a picture for remembering to an observer taken aback. There are not so many rivers in the world which flow into a waterfall. The Vrela is a rarity for that as well. And here in this place, the nature was very generous in its unique try. It is abundance of beauty in its power and magnitude of the very encounter of river with river, sense with ratio, top with bottom, reality and dreams. There are many regions in our country which by chance remained preserved from different attacks of self-called lovers of natural beauties. Luckily enough, this goddess among mountains resisted the invasion of fashionable people which, with a loss of value system, tried to destroy everything that came under their wallet. This beauty remained reserved also for the very fact that in 1981 it was pronounced the National Park, and from that time our most beautiful mountain has been under the state protection. Great geomorphological and geological diversity with specific hydrological characteristics of natural and anthropogenic origin, as well as the climate, made conditions for richness in flora with great number of endemic and relic species of plants. There are presented real natural rarities. In the first place, the Panić Panja, Panić od Omorika, and Tara is the only natural domicile for it. He persistently looked for conifer about which he heard from the local residents, which was neither a fir nor a pine or a spurs, and it grew and existed somewhere in the district of Užice. With no success of all 20 years, Panić finally found himself in the village of Zauvine at the mountain of Tara on the 1st of August in 1975. Then together, Panić and his spurs gave each other names. This tertiary endemic relic bears its name after him. As a result of favorable living conditions at Tara, with regards to species, considerably numerous fauna remained until nowadays. There are 53 species of mammal, 153 species of birds. For bear and chamois, as rather rare species, certain parts of the national park have the role of asylum, in which continuity of their autochthonous existence is secured. We are in the very heart of Tara National Park, at the locality called Biljaška Stena, in the region of Zvezda, the Star. This locality is not only known for the Panić Omorika, which you could see is quite present here. It is also used for making various films. This part of the national park is rich with versatile game, starting with bear, chamois, roe deer game, badgers, foxes, other kinds of mammal and great number of birds.
My duty in the national park is duty of supervisor, which means the control of all the activities in the Tara National Park, from tourism, construction work, up to damages made to the national park itself and to the nature.
The surveillance department of the National Park Tara has 12 people who day and night control 10 reservations in the first zone of protection in the area of 19,200 hectares, which they renew and improve by their expert work. During the winter period, one of the tasks is feeding of the roe deer game. At the breeding places, their number as well as possible diseases are observed. Apart from the roe deer game in the Tara National Park, with regards to the large game, we have bear, which is in expansion, and the number of it is increasing every year. We estimate there are between 30 and 40 animals in the area of the Tara National Park. We also have chamois, which are in the canyon part from Perudol up to the mouth of Brusnica. They suffered considerably big losses during the war in Bosnia. However, their number is increasing every year. Therefore, we have started with commercial hunt this year and the killing of chamois of the trophy value. Bears are in the caves in hibernation. They rest. We do not feed them. But as soon as spring comes up and they move from their caves, we bring food to their breeding places. This is where we monitor their number, trophy value, as well as diseases. Bear is under permanent protection and there is no hunting them in the Tara National Park, and in Serbia generally bear hunt is forbidden. Bear is a trademark of this region, and encounter with them is quite possible. There are bears here, of course. Well, when I worked in Geosonda from Belgrade, and in the night when I went home from the shift, we ran into each other. He was not even a meter from me, and I did not know how to shout to get him away. I only said, "Oh, here you are," and I spread my arms. He showed his big teeth, and he snarled. He was hairy, eyes squinting, and he stared at me. I stared at him too, and he was smarter than me. We stared at each other for maybe 1 minute. Then he turned his rear legs and started for Milekići and I towards Rasište, and so it happened. Tufty and picturesque are the images which Tara offers to us in the summertime, decorated with colors full of odors from forests and bloomy meadows. Between the reality and dream, it is washed with the morning dew at first sun rays. It would appear shamelessly in its luxurious beauty and grandeur, with power of odors of grown vegetation. It enchants and fills all senses in a slow breeze. Mind is slowly losing itself in the distance while the mountain spreads and sleepily stretches, body and juicy, offering itself unselfishly.
Nevertheless, it's more beautiful in the winter time. Its wavy slopes covered with snow transform into fairy tales.
Frost's snowy crystals, Perseus and Amoricus, bowed under the weight of white cloak which covers them, all that under the sun rays glisten into rainbow colors, shine and blind your eyes. Tara is, however, the most beautiful at the beginning of autumn. All people from the area of Užice municipality known about Tara, and there are also people from abroad who came here and know a lot about it. Tara is a gorgeous mountain, abundant with beauties, wealth, forests, pastures, and these shepherds' mole huts. In this unique oasis of beauty and health, at a height over 1,000 meters above the sea level at Mitrovac, the children's resort of Belgrade is situated, which for more than half of a century accepts children from the whole country for stay and convalescence. The children's resort Mitrovac represents a complex of pavilions built in mountaineer style. It has 600 beds in exceptional comfort, which offers ideal conditions for children to stay in nature. Extraordinary climate, enough sun, ozone, snowy winter offer the children an unforgettably good time. Contact with nature and getting to know a virginal part of this pearl of tourism at only 60 kilometers from Užice and three times that much from Belgrade. At one of the most beautiful parts of Tara, at Kaluđerske bare, there is an army institution of Tara. It is a complex of hotels, tourist catering and sports recreational buildings.
The Tara Army Institution includes the hotels Amorica and Belibor, Annex Javor, the National House Jeremičak, the agricultural property Ponikve, the army homes of Užice, Čačak, Požega, and also the canteens which are at disposal in the barracks of these cities.
The Amorica Hotel has been working from 1977 and it is situated in the area of 22,000 square meters. It has complete contents necessary for a modern guest, such as swimming pool, sauna, trim cabinet, entertainment saloons, billiard and table tennis, disco and nightclub. Out there, there are grounds for the small sports like football, basketball, volleyball, handball, etc. The Belibor is also predetermined for youth tourism and has almost the same offer as the Amorica Hotel, except for the swimming pool. The supplements to the hotels Amorica and Belibor are the Annex Javor and the National House Jeremičak, where for our guests we organize lunches of the national cuisine. The total capacity is 620 beds, out of which 320 are in the Amorica. But we do not have the attribute of the season tourism. We simply work during the whole year, so that in each period we organize those types of tourism which are significant for that period. After the winter season we have a congress tourism, then in summer season sports tourism and preparation for sports teams, and then again a congress tourism until a new winter season comes. So our capacities are full about 80% at the annual level. The mountain of Tara has exceptional climate characteristics. Mild continental and mountainous climate of Tara is of such a character that it affects treatment of asthma, bronchitis, anemia. The mountainous air also affects threatening of immunology system and makes stronger the organism in general. Therefore, the climate characteristics of Tara correspond to the type of air spa. Although man is present at Tara for centuries, the nature is entirely preserved here. The harmony of economy and ecology is the most significant precondition for a sustainable development of nature and cultural, historical values, as well as villages within the National Park of Tara. With a very good and thought-out realization of the project of sustainable development on this region, we shall more easily accomplish protection of basic cultural, historical and natural values in this region. Namely, we are witnesses of the fact that in the last period, couple of decades ago, from the times when the protected areas and national parks exist, there has also been some antagonism between ecologists and economists in Serbia and in Europe. Modern attitudes present in the European Union for more than a decade slowly reach us, meaning that ecology and economy, not only in the protected areas but also in general, have to be synchronized. This miraculous mountain gives a stimulus to a passenger and a guest so that he forever surrenders to it, and it turns to again and again, each time enthralled and repeatedly in love at first sight. It is an endless cycle of return and new encounter with a beauty. This is because you don't come to Tara for an hour or two. Who comes to Tara only once, he remains its lover for a lifetime and always returns to it. Tara faithfully waits like Penelope.